What's up, family and friends? Welcome to the Woke Nation. How are you doing? How are you coping with the coronavirus lockdown? Coronavirus pandemic. For those of you that are on the Woke Nation, I know you are enjoying your life, living your life, knowing that your life is more important than whatever you are facing or passing through. But for those of you that are still asleep, that still love God, love Jesus, Alpha, you don't see say what I don't pass, Gary. They know the tell man now. When he shelle, man go know. But now only stupid man, no one know. He Sidon. And Sidon they look. Na dog name. How is your God sustaining you? How is your God supplying your need? How is your God keeping you alive? Hope you are not wearing mask. Hope you are going about your daily business as usual. Hope you are still going to your worship or religious center to worship God, to praise God, to pray to God. Hope you are still doing all that, right? Come on. Learn from nature. They put it in the Bible when they were talking about women in, I think, 2 Corinthians chapter 11. He said, does not nature teach you this? If you don't want to learn from me, learn from nature, nature of things around you. Nature of things happening around you, how far, how things going. It should teach you that man pass God. So I titled this, Man Pass God Almighty. One of the reasons many, I didn't say few, many were still believing in God and Jesus despite their experience in this lockdown is because they are afraid. There is no chain greater than the fear of God. There is no bondage. There is no poison. There is no evil greater than the fear of God. Fear of God is why people worship imaginary God or imaginary beings. Fear of what that God, what they told them. They have not experienced that, but they wrote in the book telling them what that God has done to people before. He turned people into animals. He killed people. He drowned people. You know, he unleashed anger on people. So with that fear, they don't want to experience that. They tell them that God will sentence people to eternal death in hellfire. Fire will be burning people. Yet they will be, you know, they will not die. The moth there, or the maggot there, and the fire there, the maggot will not die, the fire will not quench. So the way they describe that terrible place is why you see many still believe that lie, that there is God Almighty. That there is God Almighty who created this heaven and earth and who controls it. There's God Almighty that everything that happens, he has knowledge of it. He is the one that permits them to happen. So they have that fear of God. I don't want bad thing to happen to me. And they extend that fear to you, like to you, like me. They say, oh, you are talking, you are mocking God. God is not mock. God will punish you. God will do this. You are bringing curse upon yourself and your family. To which I say, fuck that God, fuck that cause, fuck that God Almighty. I'm a God killer. I don't need any God to live my life. I am good without God. How about you? Are you good? I am good, perfectly good, not erroneously good, not maybe somehow good, not somewhat good, perfectly good. Without God, I decide how I live. I can keep my life. I can take my life. I have that power. And God have no such power over me. No God can give me life and no God can take my life. No God keeps me alive. No God takes my life. I have that power. Every human being have that power. And God cannot take that power from any human being. Regardless your age, you have that power to make things happen. God cannot stop you when you decide to do anything. You're supposed to know that no man is almighty. No God is almighty. But when we bring, when you bring all the people together, they become almighty. That's why I said the people are one, speaking with one language. Whatever they decide to do, whatever they imagine to do, whatever they propose to do, he said nothing will refrain them from doing that. Nothing will stop them from doing that. Not even God will stop them. That's why God Almighty, instead of stopping them, because you know he cannot stop them, he said, let me confuse them. That's why they introduce religion to you. Religion introduced God to you. And the fear of God introduced a book to you. And now you are living in that fear. Despite the facts, the evidence around you, this is coronavirus pandemic, whether it's man-made or not, no matter how it come into being, the question is this: where is that your God Almighty? God, your God Almighty failed to prevent coronavirus. Your God Almighty failed to cure anyone with coronavirus. Pastors, bishops, Pope ran away now. A man, he's been killing everybody. He's been killing the children of God. All those that have been sprinkling or covering themselves with the blood of Jesus, he killed them. All those that say it was a host, they don't care, they will still hold choir, they will still go to church, he killed them. Where is your God Almighty? I am mocking that God Almighty. If that God Almighty exists, I will not be mocking him. The reason why I am mocking God Almighty is because it does not exist. It is man-made. The religion you have, the religion you belong in, the religion you are defending, man gave it to you. There is no God that gave you that religion. It is man that gave you religion. The religion that gave you God. And that God has a book. Or some, in some religion, it doesn't have a book, but it still have your mind. Because religion rot the brain. It destroys your mind. It destroys your ability to reason, ability to think for yourself. Religion makes you become slave. Religion makes you become animals. Some of you are sheep. Some of you are goats. Some of you are birds. Some of you are serpents. In the name of faith in God and Jesus. So it is time you begin to wake up to know that there is no God Almighty. Some of you have wished me death for years now. Some of you for months now. You are expecting bad thing to happen to me. No bad thing that can happen to me that cannot happen to you. Anything you wish me will also happen to you. And the issue is this: it will not happen to me because I am not dumb like you. I'm not stupid like you. I shine my eyes. I walk by sight. I don't walk by faith. You are the one that will suffer that evil. I cannot curse you because you are my fellow human being. But if you curse me, if you wish me ill, is you are wishing yourself ill. You are cursing yourself, not me. I'm not living in the fear of God. I'm not living in the fear of wrath of God. I'm not living in the fear of curse of God. You are the one living in that. And if I don't believe in hellfire, if you believe in hellfire, may you go there. If you believe God can curse anybody, may that God curse you. If you believe God can punish anyone, may that God punish you. Do you get what I'm saying? I am not against God because God does not exist. I am against your idea of God. I am against your faith in God. I am against your fear of God. I am against your ignorance of God. I am not against you and not against God. You are real. You are like me. If I'm against you, I'm against myself. But you decided to become animals. Faith makes you animal. Faith makes you stupid. And that's what I am against. I am not here to argue with you. You are sheep. I don't argue with sheep. I don't argue with animals. I argue with my fellow human being and listen to them and say, yes, you are right or you're wrong. Then they present their evidence. Then I judge it and still make the final decision. Either you are right or wrong. I am not a sheep. I am not a follower. I am human being. I live by sight. I think and judge and make my decision. I'm not waiting for anyone to think for me. I'm not waiting for anyone to see for me. I'm not waiting for anyone to fight for me. I'm not waiting for anyone to speak for me, because I am real. I can speak for myself. I can fight for myself. How about you, God Almighty? How about the God Almighty billions of you worship and fear? Can that God speak for himself? Can that God fight for himself? Man made God. That's why man passed God. Man made God Almighty, made God all-knowing, made God invisible. That's why man passed God. If God passed man, no man would have shut down Mecca. No man would have shut down Vatican. No man would have shut down any place of worship of God. To show you that it is not God that gives man anything. God doesn't give you power. God doesn't give you wisdom. God doesn't give you knowledge. God doesn't give you strength. God does not give you anything. Instead of you to have God, why not have dog? A dog can help you. A dog can assist you. When strangers enter your compound, a dog can alert you. But God cannot do that. When coronavirus was entering the world, God did not alert anyone that worship him. No man of God, no servant of God, no child of God foresaw coronavirus. How can they see? They are blind. They are blind, led by blind, blind, following blind. And all of them are ending up in the ditch. Ditch of ignorance. Ditch of bondage, ditch of fear. That's where they are ending up. And they still have that fear. Oh, there's ditch called hellfire. I don't want to go there. There's no hellfire. The real hellfire is religion. The real hellfire, where you were born, the worm in it does not die. The fire in it does not quench. It is called religion. Those who champions it will do everything to keep it real to you who goes there. But to me, religion is fraud. Religion is sham. Religion is useless, just as God Almighty is useless. So how far, how is your God Almighty? How is your God Almighty coping with coronavirus? You say, oh, it's China, Chinese people that develop it. Let us talk about your God. Where was your God before Chinese people develop it? You say your God is all-knowing and they love everyone. If you love all your children, will you allow anyone to develop anything that will harm any of your children? Will you do that? Yes, you will say yes. God gave them free will. God gave them free will to hurt other people. God gave them free will to hurt his own children, his own worshippers. Wake up, my people. Know that God is garbage. How many of you eat garbage or eat from garbage? So why are you believing in God? Why are you hoping in God? Why are you trusting in God? Why are you still preaching God, saying God? No. What benefit you have in believing in God, in worshiping God? In reality, I'm not talking in imagination. You imagine, oh, I'm alive because of God. I'm here because of grace of God. The question is this: in reality, right now, the reality is biting you. Right now, you lack food. Right now, you lack shelter. You lack things. Where is the God Almighty? Where is that God? You believe the God of the Bible, the God of Quran, the God of Torah. Where is that God you believe exists? As old as you are, you still argue there is God. After seeing the reality that there is no God that is coming to prevent any evil from happening, there's no God that is coming to save you from evil, you still say there is God. And you are saying it as if you know what you are saying. No, you are saying it out of fear. That fear develops what is called false self-confidence or overconfidence. You have confidence, whether good or bad, God is good to me. God is good all the time. God is good all the time. Then why are you taking medicine? God is good all the time. Why are you wearing a mask? God is good all the time. Why are you crying? Why are you crying? Why are you suffering? If God is good all the time, there is no reason for you not to be enjoying all the time. There's no reason for you to suffer some of the time. You're supposed to enjoy goodness of God all the time. If God is good all the time, you used to recite it, the Lord is my shepherd. Then the last verse, it says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Is coronavirus the goodness and mercy of God? No, corona is goodness. Then virus is mercy. And I'm following you. You have to protect yourself. Why are you protecting yourself from the blessings of God? He said every good thing, every perfect thing comes from God. If everything comes from God, if everything, God is the creator, at least God said he creates evil. So if coronavirus is from God, why are you afraid of dying? You don't believe in heaven anymore? Heaven is no longer your place? You are telling me to repent or I will be born in hell. Then you believe there is heaven, you will go. But you are afraid of dying. You are afraid of contacting coronavirus and die and go to heaven. Can't you see you are the one lying to yourself, deluding yourself, deceiving yourself, blinding yourself? It's not any devil that is attacking you. You are the one attacking yourself. Man pass God Almighty in your life. That's why when you sick, you go to doctors. Because doctors pass God. God cannot heal you. God cannot treat you. You know the religious doctors, they say, oh, but the doctor say, we treat, God heal. That's bullshit. That's nonsense. If God can heal you, don't need any doctor to treat you. If God can heal you, don't need anyone to treat you. That's why the Jesus, they say in saint, he said, heal the sick. That's what Jesus said. You don't need doctor. He said, heal the sick. So you don't need to invoke doctor or to call doctor, say, oh, doctor said only God, God heals, we treat. God don't do any shit. God cannot heal, God cannot help, God cannot do anything. God is useless in reality. God does not exist. Are you still upset that hearing that? And I will say it more and more. God is useless in reality. God cannot do anything for you. Some of you, you believe there is God, but you are calling people to send money to you. You are calling people to borrow you money, to lend you money. You are calling people to give you something to assist you. Where is that God Almighty? You say he can do all things. I am here because of God. If not for God, I wouldn't have made it. Then where is that God? At your age, you still lying to yourself, claiming God this, God that. Where is God? You see some of you doing donation, saying people, give to people, do this. Where is God? You are calling people to give. As a man of God, as church, we have to give to the poor, we have to give this. You are wiser than God. You are better than God. You are nicer than God. You are stronger than God. God didn't see those people suffering. God Almighty. And God cannot provide for them. Can't you think? After this coronavirus lockdown or quarantine or whatever it is, you will still go back saying you are going to worship God. You are going to praise God. You are going to honor God. You see the last video I made, where is your tithe? They promise you those three blessings they promise you in Malachi. Where is it? He said he will give you abundance that we have no room enough to contain them. Yet you are suffering lack. He said, will the book the devourer, that he will not devour anything that concerns you. Yet you are suffering. It devour your shop. It cannot open your shop. It devour the coronavirus, stop you from traveling, doing whatever you're supposed to do. Some of you postponed your wedding, postponed your programs. All of them, you postpone them because of coronavirus. And they say all nations shall call you blessed. But see, you are living as cursed. Can't you think? Learn from this coronavirus. I'm not pitying anyone anywhere. I don't pity people anymore. Since they believe in God, since they believe there is God in charge of what is happening, I'm not pitying them. And if they call or come to me for help, I will ask them common sense questions. Unless they will deny God and Jesus. If they deny God and Jesus, with all pleasure, I will assist. Yeah. After coronavirus, churches will begin to have thanksgiving for surviving coronavirus, for surviving lockdown. And the pastors will go to Bible bringing different verses to convince them more, to make them deluded more, or delusional more. Thanksgiving. Oh, yeah. End of year now, you will see now, that must be included in their program. Thanksgiving for escaping coronavirus. You remember how many people that died? Hundreds of thousands of people died, but you made it. Why can't you thank God? I thank God, okay, I can thank God in my house. I don't need to go anywhere to thank God. But I don't need to thank God because God did not keep those people that died alive. Why are you thanking the God that kill people like you? You will be next. And when you die, people like you will also say that, you know, it's good that you died. It is time you wake up. It is time you begin to tell yourself the truth and stop deceiving yourself. Stop lying to yourself. There is no God that is coming to help you, and there's no Satan that is coming to hurt you. It is your fellow human being. Know that man passed God. That's why when you have problem, where do you go to? After all your prayers, pretending there is God, pretending God hear you, the people that do this, Muslims hit their head on the floor, or Dula is praying, or after you pretend all that, saying there is God that care about you, look at your life. Look at your life in reality. You still go to people for help. You still want to open your shop for help. You say, yeah, God walk in a mysterious way. It means God is ignorant. God walks in ignorance. That's what you mean. It's what people don't know they call mystery, which is ignorance. They are ignorant of that. Then they say it's a mystery. There's no mystery. Anything you dare to know in this world, you will know. It is time you wake up and stop being stupid by faith in Christ and Jesus, by faith in religion. Trust religion. Trust all of them. You have to be wise and live your life. Life is good. Live your life. There's no place I will be now will not enjoy my life. Village life. I love village life than American life or than city life. You say because you don't know me. If you know me, you will know that I'm saying what I already done. It was in my village as a grown-up man. In my village, I had a vision of coming to America. It was not in Lagos. It was not in Onitsha. It was not in any city in Nigeria. I went back. I packed my life. I said, I'm going back to village. But your pastor will tell you it's a curse. What make it a curse? Where I was born. Anytime I go back to my village, I get refreshment. Because that's where I was born. That's where I was born. My mother gave birth to me in that land. That is my land. Understand that you have to change the way you think. Mindset is everything. It starts with you. Change your mind. Do you want to change? Change your mind. When you change your mind, you will begin to live better. Think, where is God Almighty in all this you are suffering? If you are not suffering, how about your siblings? How about your family? How about your fellow human beings? How about those dying? Where is the God Almighty? It's garbage.